Hi, I'm Laura.
Laura, I'm gonna watch Riverdale season 3, episode 22. This is the final episode for this season 3. I had to say it. Honestly, I was one of the viewers that was really enjoying the storyline about the Gargoyle King and also about the farm. You know my obsession with the farm. During the first episode, but the middle of the season was really slow and I got bored about that, really. It was annoying them repeating those things about the Gargoyle King, about the farm. They were not giving us anything about that, just repeating the same thing again and again. And now when I'm thinking about the Gargoyle King, I'm like, really? It's not frightening anymore. I'm not afraid anymore. I want to know who is it, and that's all. On the last episode, they discovered that the Gargoyle King was Jason Blossom. Ethel told Jughead that was Jason Blossom. And no, it's not a good answer for me, because you can't bring a dead person to answer the storyline of your season. It's almost like they're not playing by the rules with the viewers, because we were trying to figure it out, to understand all of that, to make theory about who the Gargoyle King was during the time that the parents were in high school and who is in now. So to bring someone there to answer all of that, it's not playing by the rules, and it's not a good answer for me also, because Jason Blossom was already a villain on other seasons. So I want a new villain, I want something new here. To bring a dead one and to bring Jason Blossom on this Gargoyle King storyline, it's a little bit easy, and it almost feels like a soap opera, and a bad soap opera in my opinion. So yes, I'm not really enjoying this answer for the Gargoyle King storyline, and we'll see if it's really him or not. I had a theory about Dr. Cuddle Senior when the parents were in high school, and Dr. Cuddle Junior now. I'm not sure, but no, that's not the case. I'm not disappointed because my theory is wrong. I'm disappointed because the answer that the writers are giving us, it's not as good as I thought it was. So yes, I'm disappointed by the answer. The farm, I'm not sure that the farm is gonna have a real answer and a real end during this season. I think we are gonna have it still on the fourth season. So we'll see about that. Let's go for the final episode of this season. Please be good. This final episode has to be good, because really, like, the beginning of this season was really great with a lot of storylines, really interesting and all of that. The middle was slow and a little boring in my opinion, and the end is not satisfying for me. So really, be a good episode. Let's go.
We need to go save them because...
you did that. Why?
My dear.
Really, the Blossom being villains? We already saw that. Yes, please, interrupt.
Sorry. Huh? You sell organs, don't you? I'm looking to ascension is upon us. Tonight. The ascension?
She says she's giving me the Aureole. That I legit.
That's a very generous gift, aren't
you? Yes.
But still, I'm interested in where you two stand romantically.
She's pressing them, no?
The invitation saying not to tell anyone and not to bring our phones.
So it's a trap?
Yes, I think so or so. You too? But you're in the farm. How can you?
Guys.
You're beautiful.
What is this place? This is the Blossom Hunting Lodge. How did I get here? I bought you from Mr. Evermore. To my house. You naughty, naughty girl. Agatha was one of my mentors. Sons and daughters of the original Midnight One. What's happening?
Thomas.
Oh, but first, two more guests. What have I told you? No masks at the dinner table.
Please!
Whoever is underneath that mask must have had a connection to Hal and to you, Penelope. But it's not Jason, because he's dead.
Thank you!
Even though his corpse is missing. The one corpse that hasn't been accounted for, Chick. Because you called him Jason. Because you dressed him up like Jason.
You didn't murder Chick.
I recognized the kinship in him and I spared him.
He begged for mercy.
I prefer this answer, you know, because I didn't like the way that they killed him, so I'm glad that they didn't kill him.
You introduced G&G to our parents 25 years ago, and then reintroduced it this year to Chick. His name is Jason.
And the true mastermind behind it all, the true king, is you, Penelope.
She was never in the same place. With him, with the karaoke.
But now it's time to play one final round.
She was surprised that the corpse of Jason was not where it's supposed to be.
I'd start running if I were you.
Kevin, thanks. Save those eyes for the bad memories. We're getting out of this house of the devil.
Yeah, and suddenly you're sounding a lot like Betty.
Bend me the score.
Please, wake up.
Or Evelyn did.
Cheryl, we are getting ready to ascend.
I'm in no mood. I said who are...
What? What was so scary?
He was all alone in the pit to save his home.
Nice! Archie fighting again.
It's just a fight. I'm fighting all year.
You've been fighting since the Red Circle, and since the Red Circle, I don't like this side of you. Okay, you just killed the man. Are you happy? I think that Penelope is filming all of that quest, all of those quests, just to... blackmail them.
Monster, are you?
Cheryl.
Cheryl, I love you.
Why would you do such a thing? To my own brother? My brave brother?
Wait, what?
Brother. No!
Ooh, that was what she saw. It took the body of Jenna.
You will each take turns spinning the bottle and drinking from the chosen chalice. Remember, we're watching.
See? We're watching. I think she's filming.
No. You've completed your challenge. And proven your loyalty.
What?
Yes. None of the caddies was poisoned.
The game was testing if you had honor and loyalty. None of the chalices were poisoned.
No, on the contrary. All of the chalices were poisoned.
They are cute. Okay, they are cute. I can feel that. But I'm not shipping them because it's almost like the writer are forcing us to like them. Don't show Cheryl. Okay, that's you, Alice. That's okay. Yes? I don't want anything bad to happen to Alice.
Why make our law kink? Who doesn't want to be king? Who doesn't want blood sacrifices made in the name?
Yes, fast. No, no, I want answers. Yes. That's why I'm not satisfied by this answer. The Blossoms being the villains already saw that. Yes, that's nice and that's sweet. And Alice, you're not gonna save Alice? Damn, nice. Oh, it's a black hood? No. To kill him or to... I'm not gonna cry for him, but I can feel Betty.
What are you thinking you're doing? Finding our prize. We won, didn't we? Then kill them. Kill them all!
Cheryl with elbow. Love that, love that, love that. Okay, you're safe. You're the red queen. You're sweet, the four of you together.
They left me. I wanted to go, but they said that someone had to stay behind to explain what happened.
What happened?
The worthy ascended, of course.
Who did? Where's my mom and Polly?
Gone.
Come on. They can't just disappear. Where are they?
Come home, Gigi.
You're continuing to visit his body? Oh, my baby. You're crazy.
Hermione and Lazarus are under arrest for conspiracy to commit murder. Your own husbands. Major Smith of the FBI. Is ready for very many times. Had someone on the inside. Someone tasked with getting close to him. Your mother. She's working with us.
Alice, I love you even more now.
I'm Charles, your brother.
Charles?
It's our half brother. It's pretty crazy, right?
Yes, a little.
To the future.
This is not gonna end well. It's a little bit like Souviens-toi l'été dernier. But where is Jacket? It's written to be like us believing that they killed Jacket. But I'm not buying it. Okay, you know what? That end and those answers to who is the Gargoyle King, who he was, who is the Black Hood. All of that, it's not as good as I wanted to be during the beginning of the season, during the time that the writers were building all of that storyline, but it's not as bad as I thought it could be. after watching the last episode about it. I'm happy that Jason Blossom is not the real answer for the Gallo King. The story about Chick, Al and Penelope working together, it means sense. And okay, I can buy it, but I'm still not satisfied by it because the Blossoms being the villains of the show, we already saw that since 2 and 3 seasons now, and it feels a little bit easy to again using them to be villains. I want new villains, I want new things on this show with 3 seasons and each one being like 22 or 24 episodes. You can build other villains than just them. I'm really happy about the story about the farm, you know my obsession with the farm, but all the surprises about the farms never disappointed me, because all the times there were surprising, all the answers, all the things that we learned about the farm were surprising, with Edgar, with Evelyn being the wife, one of the wife of Edgar, with them selling organs, with this ascension things where they all disappeared. I'm happy that Alice is still alive. Alice was finally a spy for the FBI, but I'm not sure that I'm buying really that. I'm buying it, okay, I understand it, I get it. But all the things that she did, all of those episodes, I'm not sure that all of that is really working with the fact that she is a spy for the FBI. Charles being alive and being an FBI agent, it's interesting, I think, for the next season. It's gonna be interesting to see him talking with Betty and Jughead. He's the brother of the two of them, and the two of them are together, so it's gonna be weird, but also really interesting to see that. That thing at the end, that scene about them burning their clothes, it's really like in the movie, Souviens-toi l'été dernier in French, it's almost a wink for that movie, but they're trying to make us believe that they killed someone and that they killed Jughead, because Jughead is not there and they are burning his thing. I don't know the name of it in English, but I'm not really buying it, because I don't think that they can kill a person, a character like that. I'm not sure that a show like that can kill one of the main characters of the show. Riverdale, it's not a show like that. They are not able to do that with the viewers that they have. It's not like Game of Thrones or The 100 or The Walking Dead. It's not a show like that. It's more like an high school show, and in a show like that, we are not expecting that they can kill one of the main characters. So I'm not really buying that. It was this high at the beginning of the season. It was really like during it, with the episode 20 and 21, and with the episode 22, foot. But really, like the beginning is still here and the end is still here, so it's not as good as they promised us to do, to write. So yes, this is the end of the season 3 of Riverdale. Tell me if you are thinking the same about this episode and all of this season in the comments. You know me, you know that I love to talk with you on the comment about a show or about an episode. So tell me if you are thinking the same about this one. And okay, that's all for Riverdale for season 3. So I'll see you on the season 4 if you are just watching my reaction videos about Riverdale. And if you want, I'm making also reaction videos about The 100, Game of Thrones, Vikings, Peaky Blinders and The Walking Dead. And maybe I'm gonna begin to make reaction videos about Fear the Walking Dead, Stranger Things, and maybe more. So if you want to catch up with me, you can subscribe. So it's all for Riverdale for now, and it's all for me for now. So bye for now. Bye!